The day has finally come. Microsoft is here to embrace, extend, and finally extinguish. You are all right. Microsoft could never be trusted. Now that I have your attention, let's talk about a fun situation that happened in the Linux kernel recently. So, the Linux kernel of today is not a hobby project. There are hobbyists that work on it, don't get me wrong, but it is not the project of the 90s where Linus was just hanging out at university, arguing on mailing lists and BBS forums with professors over whether Linux was a good idea, whether a monolithic kernel was a good idea, and all the fun stuff that we've talked about before. Today, everyone from Google to Red Hat to Amazon to Intel to Nvidia, and of course, even Microsoft, contribute code to the Linux kernel. It's in everyone's best interest to have this one open source project that everybody contributes to that powers a lot of the world's computing, even if not on the desktop itself. Yeah, I do use Linux on the desktop, but let's be honest, most people don't, and it is getting more popular thanks to gaming, but it's probably never going to be at the scale of something like Windows. But with so many companies contributing to one project, along with the pretty negative history that Microsoft has with Linux, go back to the early 2000s, have a look at the Halloween documents. You know, Microsoft back then just wasn't exactly a big fan. They've very much changed their tune because they realized, you know, how much money they can save by being involved in Linux and how much people want to use Linux and how much money they can make from supporting Linux and all that fun stuff. But sometimes you get these patch sets from a Microsoft developer which cause a massive regression in kernel security, very almost make their way into a production release before thankfully being caught by an Intel and AMD engineer testing out code and realizing that, nobody actually checked this. This all stems from a patch set by Mike Rappaport. I don't know how to say it properly. Regardless, this is a Microsoft developer. Now, this is a Microsoft developer that has a kernel.org address. This makes it a little bit more annoying to confirm they are. However, looking at their LinkedIn, they have been at Microsoft for the past 7 months. Previously to that, they've been at like IBM and various other places though. So yes, it is a Microsoft developer. This version of the patch set is from when they're at Microsoft. We'll get to it being version 7 in just a moment, because that ruins my fun, but don't worry about that. These patches add support for using large ROX pages for allocations of executable memory on x86. ROX in this context stands for read-only executable. Now again, take note of the version, version 7. This version of the patch set was released on the 23rd of October, 2024. However, the very first version the RFC sent up to the Linux kernel, this is from April 11th, 2024. So at that time, yes, he was still an IBM employee. He had not yet started at Microsoft. But we will get into something a little bit later that does keep it involved with Microsoft. Do not worry about that. The approach taken is to allocate ROX memory along with writable but not executable memory and use the writable copy to perform relocations and alternatives patching. After the module text gets into its final shape, the content of the writable memory is copied into the actual ROX location using text poking. Now, after 7 public iterations and 8 if you want to include the RFC, most of the issues have been ironed out. However, I did say there was one thing tied to being at Microsoft for this regression being introduced. The patch with the regression was not there at the start. That patch was first introduced in patch version 6. That was October 16th, 2024. At that time, still at Microsoft. We're back, boys. So the problematic patch in question is patch number 8. Enable ROX caches for module text on 64-bit. Enable execmems cache of PMD-sized pages mapped as ROX for module text allocations on 64-bit. The one part that's really, really important, though, is this line right here. Select Arch has exec mem rocks if x86 64. So basically, enable this on this. Now, this patch was reviewed by Lewis Chamberlain. If my search is correct, I believe he is a Samsung employee. I don't know what kind of review he did, but this patch never should have made it this far. It never should have been in the position where it was about to be merged, because it's very clearly not working correctly. And luckily, it didn't make it any further. So this was submitted on October 23, 2024. The problem was spotted January 12th, 2025. Luckily, the patch had not yet been merged. Otherwise, this would have caused a much, much, much bigger problem. This is just someone who is testing things out early. So this person from Intel noticed a bit of a regression. The regression is not actually the core problem, though. It's just another symptom. This breaks resume from hibernation on my older lake laptop. Fortunately, this still reverts cleanly. PStore managed to catch the following oops. Seems to blob on bringing up the second HT of the second P core for whatever reason. This is just a side effect. This is a problem, right? Yeah, hibernation not working. Yeah, big deal. But like, not actually the main issue here. Following that, an AMD developer chimed in, thinking that a patch from a few days ago may have addressed it. That being this one right here. Fix ROCs cache usage in Zen PV guests. The ROCs cache does not assume support for large pages. It just had a bug when dealing with base pages, and the patch below should fix it. Restricting ROCs cache only for configurations that support large pages makes sense on its own, because there's no real benefit from the cache on such systems. But it does not fix the issue, but rather covers it up. And that patch did not, in fact, fix the problem. Still blows up with that one. And then another Intel developer chimed in, realizing kinda what the problem was. There's definitely breakage with that module writable address nonsense in alternative.c that will not be fixed by that patch. The very simplest thing at this point is to remove select arch has exec mem rocks if x86-64 and then try again next cycle. Clearly it's not working, so just block it for now and then move on until later. Now this email by itself isn't actually a patch, so the following email was a patch that actually went and made that change. Now the real point of concern here is some of the CFI variants crash and burn. CFI stands for Control Flow Integrity. There is an implementation of this in the kernel known as Control Flow Enforcement Technology, CET, Shadow Stack. Control Flow Enforcement Technology, CET, covers several related x86 processor features that provide protection against control flow hijacking attacks. CET can protect both applications and the kernel. CET introduces Shadow Stack and Indirect Branch Tracking, IBT. A shadow stack is a secondary stack allocated from memory which cannot be directly modified by applications. When executing a call instruction, the processor pushes the return address to both the normal stack and the shadow stack. Upon function return, the processor pops the shadow stack copy and compares it to the normal stack copy. If the two differ, the processor raises a control protection fault. IBT verifies indirect call/JMP targets are intended as marked by the compiler with ENDBR opcodes. Not all CPUs have both shadow stack and indirect branch tracking. Today, in the 64-bit kernel, only user-space shadow stack and kernel IBT are supported. So shadow stack helps to protect against an attack known as return-oriented programming, and indirect branch tracking for call or jump-oriented programming. Both of these have considerable amounts of documentation from people who are considerably smarter than I am, so I'll leave some links in the description down below, assuming that I don't forget to. Now, our AMD developer from earlier is annoyed this even happened in the first place in this email right here. I just love it how this went in without a single x86 maintainer ACK. It broke a bunch of things, and then it is still there instead of getting reverted. Let's not do this again, please. It's funny for me, right? Like, I get to make a dumb video like this, but I can understand why if you're in this position, you probably just don't want to deal with it. You want to make sure that things are all signed off correctly, the correct people are checking things, and things are in hopefully a good state by the time they make it here. This is never going to happen. There will never come a time where things are actually checked before they make their way into a project. Whether it's the Linux kernel, whether it's something else, there's always going to be regressions from patches because the correct people don't check things, because the correct tests aren't run, because that's just the way it is. But hey, at least for that person that was having those hibernation issues, this does fix their problem. So good for them, I guess. This was just a dumb little fun video that I wanted to do. And hey, I hope you enjoyed it. Things like this just randomly happen in the kernel. It's always fun to just... It's always fun to peek into that world and just see what's going on in there. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to the Libera Pay link in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me and the kernel.